lost so much already. I don't want to lose you too.
Ain't it just like a tear to go and blur out?
The letter showed up in my mailbox with no tracks in the snow.
You're not thinking about going back there, are you?
I gotta do something. This is all I got.
Ain't it just like love to leave a mark on the skin and underneath?
So Sam, first, you know, it seems like with Hacksaw Ridge and this, like you've done a couple of movies now that deal with kind of like faith and mm-hmm. and believing in yourself. If it wasn't a shack, do you have like a place where you would kind of go to like recenter yourself and kind of where you think you would find, you know, some type of peace or clarity?
Well, I like getting off the grid quite a bit. And if I'm there with my family, that's the peace. That's what I find. You know, I don't have social media or any of those kind of things that can give us headaches. So I throw caution to the wind, and I just, it can be anywhere in the world, but as long as I'm with my family, that gives me the peace. Yeah.
I know you left the UK at a young age to go to Australia.
Oh man, I was about 2 months.
But
I was a sprog.
I left New York young to go live down south, but I still feel like a New Yorker.
I'm Australian. Well, when you're 2 months here, what do you remember? Someone cutting the umbilical cord. That's about it. So I don't have any ties to the UK. I'm Australian. Now I live in New York, so I walk around with a Knicks jersey.
So now you got the Knicks jersey. You feeling that?
Well, I've been on and off, you know, like in New York for the last 10 years. So 10 years ago is when I started following them.
Yeah.
Yeah. And my boys, one's from New York. He got born in New York. The other boy was born in L.A., so there's going to be a big rivalry there.
Yeah, that's going to be a problem.
Yeah, it's good. I like it.
as an actor, when you have a script that's been adapted from a novel, do you go and read the novel as source material to back up the script to get anything else?
Yeah, it's more to see what parts they'd left out, because obviously it's very hard to take the whole dense novel and translate it into a 90-minute film. So. Right. You're seeing what's missing, and out of what's missing, is there something important that we should put back in? So that's what I did.
Yeah. Was there anything in the shack that was like that you had to take from the book to either like insinuate in your acting that wasn't?
It was more what other themes matching. You know, this theme of forgiveness. That was central to me. Something that I could relate to, learning how to forgive others and forgive God for letting bad stuff happen and essentially learning how to forgive yourself. They were themes that I really wanted to resonate and make sure that they were in.
Yeah. That really reminded me of the Dylan Roof tragedy that happened in the South, where the victim's family like forgave him for murder.
Week after.
Yeah.
Yeah, incredible.
Yeah.
But that's the message, that if the shack is a parable for we all hold on to so much anger and frustration and grief with what's happening to us in this world, and especially in these times, it can compound and compact. And the shack is what happens, what you build out of that. So the book is basically showing you that you can let that go. It's gonna be a process and it's gonna take time, but there's a bit where the guy is holding like a bug, a small bug, he can squash it like it's nothing. And my character says to the bug, "I won't squash you, I forgive you." And says, "I don't feel any different." But the God turns around and says, "Well, but it's not going to happen straight away. If you keep saying it over and over again, it will eventually help you heal."
Yeah.
And I think that's what happened in that situation, by them saying, "Okay, we forgive you for what happened." It wasn't automatically forgiveness, but it takes you on that path. And I think that's a great lesson for everyone to learn.
You're the Almighty God, right? You know everything. You're everywhere, all at once. You have limitless power. Yet somehow, you let my little girl die. When she needed you most, you abandoned her.
I never left her.
If you are who you say you are, where were you when I needed you?
Son, when all you see is your pain, you lose sight of me.
I think everybody deals with, I mean, hopefully nobody has to deal with some of the situations that your character was dealing with his family, but everybody kind of deals with loss and maybe being angry at...
Absolutely, because we're all a bit lost. We don't really know why we're here.
Yeah.
Like, no one can tell you that answer. So out of that lost, we do get confused and frustrated and attack each other and have so much aggression. Well, how do you get to the peace and the calm? Because in the end, you're only here for a short time.
So. Yeah. And last question, I know you're about to revisit the character of Jake Scully, and it's been 8 years. When you've done a movie and you're coming back as in a sequel, does your character have to age with...
Yeah, he's changed.
With your awesome maturity?
James Cameron's a really smart man and understands. Yeah, that was 8 years ago. So Jake, 8 years ago, that character was a lot like me, rebellious, headstrong, could save the world like that.
Yeah.
But now I'm a father and I've changed. So he's put that into the character. So my character has children and he's going through the responsibilities of fatherhood, matched with the responsibilities of being a hero on this other planet. So those stories are going to be a fantastic spectacle, but essentially they're about family. And I think that's very unique and very smart when it comes to blockbusters.
Well, Sam, always good seeing you on screen and better.
Nice, man. Nice talking to you.
Thank you.
Cool.
Thank you, Jamal. Thank you.